Sometimes you want to run your application on a particular set of nodes. For example, your app requires a local SSD disk and only one instance group in your cluster has it. Or perhaps in the cloud you have on-demand instance group and spot group that is much cheaper, but your application may be down for some time. In this situation, the general approach is to use Kubernetes node labels to schedule your pods. In this video, we will go over 5 examples. First, we will use node selector to constrain the pod to run on a particular set of nodes. Then we will convert node selector to a more advanced node affinity selector. We will define the hard requirement and then we will use soft constraints to recommend where the pod should be scheduled. In the third example, we will use pods labels instead of relying on node labels to spread pods between multiple nodes for high availability. The final example will do exactly the opposite. It will require Kubernetes scheduler to place pods on the same node. Let's start with the simplest approach is to use node selector. It's a field of pod spec. It specifies a map of key value pairs. For the pod to be eligible to run on a node, the node must have each of the indicated key value pairs as labels. Usually, you don't have to add labels to the nodes manually. It is handled by the tool that you use to create instance groups. Or in the cloud, you just add those labels when you create a cluster. For this example, I will add node labels manually. We have Kubernetes cluster hosted in AWS with 2 instance groups. Each contains one single node. At this point, they have similar labels, but one instance group uses on-demand more expensive virtual machines and the other spot VMs. First, let's get all the nodes in the cluster by running kubectl get nodes. We have 2 instances. Rerun the same command and add show labels. Unfortunately, it's a bit messy, since AWS and ecoctl adds lots of labels to the nodes out of the box. Technically, we can use node group name label equal to spot and other equal to on demand to place the pod. For the first example, let me add labels manually anyway with the kubectl label nodes command. Now let's check if the node has this label. Next, create a deployment and use node selector to constrain the pods to run on that node with the role equal to spot label. Let's go back to the terminal and apply it. You can add -oy to the kubectl get pods command to verify the placement. This will show the node where the pod runs. You can see that the pod runs on a node with our label. Let me show you what will happen if you make a mistake when using a node selector. Let's make a typo in the label. Now pod is in pending state. To debug this issue, you can describe the pod. Here you can find the error. 2 nodes didn't match pod's node affinity selector. Alright, let's move on to a more advanced placement method to affinity. Node selector provides a very simple way to constrain pods to nodes with a particular labels. The affinity-anti-affinity feature greatly expands the type of constraints that you can express. You can use logical AND operation. You can indicate whether it's a soft or hard requirement. Soft means scheduler will try to follow your label selection. If it fails, it will still schedule the pods on any available node. You can constrain the pods not only based on the node labels, but against labels on other pods running on the same node as well. In general, try to use affinity instead of node selector all the time. Let's start with node affinity. It's a very similar to node selector. It allows you to constrain pods based on the labels of the nodes. There are currently 2 types of node affinity, required during scheduling and preferred during scheduling. The first one is hard requirement and the second is soft. Let's take a look at the example. It's basically the same as node selector from the previous example. It must be scheduled on the node with label role equal to spot since it's a required during scheduling type. Then we have a key of the label equal to role. Then you can see the operator in being used in this example. The new node affinity syntaxis supports the following operators. In, not in, exists, does not exist, greater than, lower than. Next is the preferred during scheduling example, similar to the previous. But if the scheduler isn't able to satisfy the requirements, it will still schedule the pod on any available node. Here we have additional wait attribute. This score is combined with other scores of the node priority functions for the node. The nodes with the highest total score are most preferred. You can use not only node labels, but you can define constraints based on other pods running on the same node. For example, I often use it with applications that have to be highly available, such as Nginx Ingress Controller. You would want to deploy all your replicas of the Ingress Controller on different nodes. If one node fails or just upgraded by Kubernetes, you always have Nginx Ingress Controller on other nodes that can take the request. For example, if you have two replicas of your controller deployed on the same node and then that node goes down, all your applications that use Ingress will be unable to accept any requests till Kubernetes relocates your Ingress Controller. Let's take a look at the example of pod anti-affinity. You can use either required or preferred, same as with node affinity. Then we're going to use pod labels to make sure that only one single replica runs per node. Also, we need two replicas for this example. Let's apply the deployment and get the pods. You can see that pods are spread between nodes. For the last example, let's modify this deployment to collocate Nginx controllers on the same node. Now they deployed on the same Kubernetes node. If you want more videos like this, subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.